Particles of light, called photons, do not usually coalesce to form fluids in the way that particles of matter do. They have neither a mass nor do they interact with themselves. However, modern semiconductor devices can be used to change this. First, it is possible to trap photons between two tiny mirrors so that they live in a two-dimensional plane in which they have a mass. Second, the photons can be brought into resonance with electron-hole pairs in the semiconductor to which they couple strongly. This forms particles called polaritons that are a composite between the two and that interact with themselves. Quantum mechanics is usually only visible on tiny scales. However, it is possible to synthesize large-scale quantum matter out of polaritons, where all the particles behave in unison as one big quantum state called a condensate. Condensates often exhibit bizarre behavior called superfluidity. This phenomenon was first discovered in liquid helium, where at very low temperatures, it flows without friction, cannot rotate except in the form of tiny, tornado-like vortices, and can even spontaneously empty itself out of its container and onto the floor.
Superfluid behavior has been seen with polaritons. In particular, they can flow without friction past defects. But whether this is the same effect, what has been seen in liquid helium, is not always clear. The problem is that polaritons decay very quickly due to the photon leaking out of the cavity, so we need an external laser drive which can alter its properties.
A fundamental property of superfluids is that they do not respond to rotating forces, but do respond to pushing forces. In our paper, we examine whether evidence of frictionless flow in coherently driven polaritons, that is, where the light is injected tuned to polariton energies and momenta, is evidence of superfluidity by calculating the response of the system to pushes and rotations, and taking the difference. Surprisingly, while our result shows that the system does indeed not respond to rotations, it does not respond to pushes either. Instead of a superfluid, this is a new type of rigid quantum matter that is unresponsive to all perturbations. Therefore, experimental observations of frictionless flow in this system are of this new rigid state rather than another superfluid. We also found that while perturbing the system can change the occupation of the rigid state, which is distinct from inducing a current, even this effect disappears around the experimentally observed regime. Unlike for incoherently driven polaritons, coherent driving restricts the low energy dynamics of the system by fixing the phase of the quantum state. We found this property to be the cause of the rigidity in the system.
Future experimental work will be needed to understand better the properties of this new state of matter. And also computer simulation will be useful to understand how it behaves. Experimental groups worldwide working in quantum technologies have already started building devices using polaritons. So the more we know about this synthetic state of light, the better.